Ray and Frank are both very focused on their tone. They're very like specific. They're both different tones and they both put a lot of work into it. Like they'll try all different kinds of gear, but they're both really good at dialing in their sounds.
It's audible. Mm-hmm. It's certainly, I mean, I don't know specifically how fine-tuned these adjustments are, because depending on the person, you'll get more into like the specifics and subtleties of something that maybe only you can hear. But whatever they were doing in combination with what Doug was able to do, man, one of my favorite things.
It's funny you mentioned Sleep too, because Sleep is probably also my favorite song off Black Parade.
Really?
Because of the intensity, because of the wall of guitars. Yeah. Like I'm a big fan of walls of sound. That's why I like bands like the Ramones so much, because the way they played those songs, even on that first record, which they probably didn't have a lot of time to make it, there's this wall of sound there. And later they would get even more into that kind of wall of sound.
Yeah, I'm definitely with you. That definitely can be a make or break for me. So, yeah.
So are you using a lot of plugins and stuff like that? Are you miking real amps, or are you looking for amps that have a vintage sound?
What I did was YouTube, because I'm not really an electric guitar player in the way that I'd like to be. I've mostly been playing and writing acoustic, and then I'll bring it to like production. And if I can, I'll have engineers come to the house, because I'm just not a good enough engineer yet. So it takes me a long time to, you know, track songs. But yeah, I went to YouTube and there's one guy who did a cover of Sleep where the tone is close enough that it's like, okay, that's definitely a usable tone. And so I have a couple songs where I would really like that strong a guitar tone, because it would make or break the song.
Right.
And so my plan is like to contact this guy and see what he can do, because I'm also not sure whether or not he was playing to a track. If Sleep was underneath and most of that tone was dominated by what was actually tracked and mixed. It's something I'm chasing. I'm always chasing it. And it's unfortunate because I've written like four songs that need it to survive.
I'll put you, you know, I'll introduce you to Doug, and he will have a lot of insight as to how to get those guitar sounds, how to attain Nemesis. Okay.
Does he know of any of the people? I suppose that's more of a conversation for him, but... Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, if it's that killer and it's something you can just get, I may end up buying it, but likely I'll hire it out to a guy, because I'm also not a good enough player to live up to Nemesis, I don't think. So, yeah.
I bet you would surprise yourself.
Okay.
Using Nemesis does something to you. It changes how you play. Because I believe guitar tones can actually kind of change how you play, obviously. You're responding to the feedback, the instrument, and the pedal, and the amp is giving you.
It gives you confidence, so you become a better player, and also you're responding to the characteristics of, if it's like a vocal chain when you're tracking, or you're playing up the characteristics of that tone and seeing what it can and can't do. And when you guys were recording that particular song, was the construction of it, and again, this might be like more of a Ray or Frank thing, was it premeditated, or did you compose within Nemesis?
The notes first. So I had the song kind of in my head first. I knew how I kind of wanted it to go. Then we all kind of started to collaborate on it. But I had initially kind of heard those notes.
Is that often how it happens with you? Do you like write stuff and you can hear the production in your head?
Yeah. The thing about me, like, and I realize how like lucky I am to kind of have this, but I hear music in my head all the time. I'll just be like walking around and I'll just hear it. Sometimes I'm actually pretty good at memorizing this stuff, but then sometimes I'll just sing it into my phone. And a lot of these songs start that way. I just sing them in, I sing all the parts, and then I record them. Another thing that I like to do, or I just have found myself doing, is I'll be in a conversation with someone and somebody will say something, like a couple sentences.
Like, but
I'll only hone in on a fragment of the sentence.
Yeah.
I'll kind of like narrow it down to like four of those words, three of those words that they've just said casually in conversation. And then just those words could be inspiration enough to write like an entire song.
You know,
just hearing the word.
Well, because it's a specific like feeling and attitude. And do you have like, I don't have it like you where like I hear the fully formed music in my head. For me, like I can do production in my head exclusively, but it takes me like an hour. So I'm in the bathroom with an acoustic for an hour with like a voice memo. while just going and I'm composing like guitar and piano, drums and whatever other instruments that I hear, but I don't hear it fully formed. Do you have, and speaking with like getting something like out of words, do you have like any form of synesthesia, or do you see things when you listen to it?
Yeah, you know, I think one of the things that was happening in my chem is I was seeing these kind of visuals play out in my head as we would be doing something.
Yeah.
Sometimes that would make it to the video we would shoot, but other times it was just the images playing in my head. Like Mama, that song had a ton of imagery.
Another favorite from the album. The way that fades in is like nothing else I've ever heard.
That was fun. That was a fun one to do.